Alright, okay, so first type of radiation is an alpha particle. Okay, first type of radiation is an alpha particle. And of the three types of radiation that we are going to talk about, an alpha particle has the lowest amount of energy. An alpha particle, the little symbol for alpha is, it kind of looks like a little fish. It is a lowercase Greek letter alpha. Great thing about alpha particles is that because they are so low energy, they can be stopped by paper. So if you try to shoot me with an alpha radiation gun, I just make it myself a paper shield and you can't get me. No, we are not doing a lab activity where we throw alpha particles at each other. I actually was asked that earlier today. Okay.
What happens if you do get hit?
If you do get hit, then you are just exposed to radiation.
Just
radiation. Prolonged exposure to radiation can cause cancer. It can cause some other issues as well. But keep in mind that alpha particles are the lowest energy, so we're not quite as concerned about that as we would be about some of the others. But we also try and take precautions, definitely against gamma rays. Okay. Who just said that? Where'd that come from, Cooper? That's a good question. I wouldn't think so, because I mean your clothes are thicker than paper, but your clothes are porous too. But then again, so is paper. So, alpha particles are made of two protons and two neutrons, meaning that you guys, what's the mass of an alpha particle?
Four.
Yes, why?
Because protons are one and two are, n is one.
Yep, protons and neutrons both have masses of one, so if I have two protons, two neutrons, the mass is four. The symbol in an equation for an alpha particle would be 4, 2, alpha. Remember that the top number is our mass number, the bottom number is our atomic number. So this is the mass, this is the number of protons. We also, you guys, an alpha particle is the equivalent of a helium atom, so you might also see it written like this, because we know that helium does have two protons and a mass of four. This covers a little bit of learning target number one. Okay.
So helium can cause cancer?
No. No, helium cannot cause cancer, at least not that I'm aware of. Okay, what this is saying is that for this type of radiation, this is what's released. Okay, you guys, when things undergo radioactive decay, it's because they're trying to become stable. Okay, they're trying to become stable. And so, when a substance undergoes alpha decay, what's going to happen to the mass of that substance? It's going to get smaller. By how much?
How?
No. What's the mass of an alpha particle, guys? If my substance shoots off an alpha particle, the mass is going to get smaller by how much? By four. Okay, because it released something with a mass of four. An example I gave to a class earlier, they were kind of having trouble visualizing it. If I had you guys pulled a 4-pound weight and step on a scale, you'd have a certain weight, right? But then if I had you get rid of the 4-pound weight and get back on the scale, how much would your weight go down? 4 pounds, right? Okay, so the mass goes down four. What's gonna happen to the atomic number? How much is it going to go down? Guys, knock it off with the tables back there. Guys, atomic number is the number of which particle? Atomic number is the number of protons.
Oh, so we're supposed to have by two.
So So yeah, it just goes down by two because there are two protons in that alpha particle. Keenan.
So it would create a new element?
Yes, it would create a new element. So for example, if I have uranium 238. Okay, I have uranium 238, and I tell you that it undergoes alpha decay. So if this is what I start with and it shoots off an alpha particle, what is it that I'm left with? And so what this ends up being, guys, is a math problem. Sure. 4 plus what is 238?
234.
234, yeah? 2 plus what is 92?
90.
90. What's element 90?
Thorium.
So yeah, exactly what Keenan just said. If a substance undergoes alpha decay, it winds up making something else. And what happens is that you have this unstable isotope. It goes through the decay process and releases this particle, and you wind up with a new element. Now, what will happen is if this isn't stable, then it will decay. And it will continue to decay until it becomes something that's stable. Okay? Can I go on? Yeah? Okay, so I'm going to slide this up because now, you guys, I want to talk about the second type of radiation. And the second type of radiation is a beta particle. Is that still recording?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Okay. Okay, so we've got a beta particle. And of the three types, the beta particle, this one has medium energy. The symbol for a beta particle is the Greek letter beta. And it looks like a bee with a long tail. Because this one has a little bit higher energy than alpha radiation, I need a little bit more to stop it. And so this one, in this case, I'm going to need a plastic suit, or I might need some foil. I can wrap myself up in foil and protect myself from beta particles. All right. What in the heck is released during beta decay? An electron. Okay, a beta particle is made of one electron. And if that's the case, what's the mass of a beta particle? Huh?
One.
What's the mass of an electron?
1/2000.
1/2000-ish, right? And so we round that to how much? Zero. Okay, now we know that it can't truly be zero, but it's pretty darn close, and so we just don't even account for it. So we're saying all that's released is an electron, and that's really not going to affect my mass. Okay, my symbol for my beta particle is either going to be 0, negative 1, beta, or 0, negative 1, E for electron. I can use either of those symbols to represent beta particles. So now when a substance undergoes beta decay, what's going to happen to its mass? When it shoots off a beta particle, what's going to happen?
Zero.
Its mass is going to stay the same because the mass of that beta particle is zero. So the mass stays the same. And the atomic number, this is going to seem a little bit confusing, okay? The atomic number goes up by one. Atomic number goes up by one. show you why. If I have 231.91 Pa, which I think is something like protactinium or something to that effect, and I tell you that it undergoes beta decay, what substance does it become? If you guys remember, when my protons and my electrons are equal, I have that neutral substance. Here, I'm saying that I'm releasing an electron, and so when I do the math, 0 plus what is 231?
231.
We said the mass didn't change. But then if I look at this, you guys, what number plus negative 1 or what number minus 1 is 91? 92. So you can see that this number, yes, it's uranium because I look up element 92. You can see that the atomic number went up by 1. Can I go on? Yeah? Okay, we have one more type of radiation to talk about. Am I still recording?
Yes, you are.
Okay, perfect. Third type of radiation is no longer a particle. Third type of radiation is called a gamma ray. Third type of radiation is called a gamma ray. And of the three types of radiation, this one has the highest energy. And the symbol is a lowercase Greek letter gamma. And it kind of looks like a funky R or maybe a funky Y. This one is the one that I really need some major protection from. A hazmat suit? You need more than a hazmat suit. You need a lead suit or a concrete suit.
Jeez.
However, I can't remember the exact thickness, but I'm thinking it's like at least a foot of concrete. So clearly you're not going to be wearing a concrete suit.
I'm all right with that.
Okay.
Yeah, if you don't, you're going to get cancer.
Lead. Okay.
And if you wear a lead, then you're going to get lead poisoning.
True. You guys, think about when you get x-rays, like at the dentist or something, they cover you up with that lead blanket, the lead vest thing. Okay? X-rays actually have less energy than gamma rays. And so, if lead will stop a gamma ray, obviously lead's going to be able to stop that x-ray that has lower energy. And so, they put that lead over you to protect all your...
That's heavy.
It is heavy, but isn't that better than a concrete blanket?
Or cancer.
Or cancer. Patrick.
Is there something stronger than gamma?
No.
Okay.
Okay, so you guys, gamma rays do not actually release particles. That's why it's not called a gamma particle. It's a gamma ray, because all that gets released here is energy. Okay, all that gets released here is energy, and the symbol is 00, and then that funky little gamma. So what do you think the mass is of a gamma ray? No mass. Okay, it's not a particle, it's energy. So when a substance...
Is it invisible?
Yes, it is. When a substance undergoes gamma decay, what's going to happen to the mass?
Nothing.
Nothing, it stays the same.
Ow.
What's going to happen to the atomic number? It also stays the same. And so I had somebody earlier ask me, so since this one is the highest energy, is this one the most confusing? No, I actually think this one is probably the easiest one. Because, you guys, if I tell you that I have plutonium, 244, and I tell you that it undergoes gamma decay, what do I end up with?
Plutonium.
Plutonium. What's my top number?
244.
And what's my bottom number?
94.
And it's the same element, because all that was released was energy. Okay? Will somebody push stop, please?